Welcome back, viewers, to a character spotlight of Age of Ultron Captain America. I just got him up to level 30, so let's see what we can do with him. His passive is Stalwart Defender. Captain America takes more than 10% damage in a single attack, and excess damage is reduced by 50%. I'm guessing that's 10% of his maximum hit points. He's a stamina-based character, and his leader bonus is Caution, increased defense and evasion. Very nice. Okay, let's see his isoslotting. He has 3 blue, 3 green, and 2 purple. So, for my point, I've added up so I can get a lot of evasion on him. So you can see I have 3600 evasion, 2500 accuracy, 2100 speed, 3800 defense, 2000 attack, and 3500 health. Now I also have, you know, classics on the ISO sets on him. I have Indomitable, Unstoppable, and Reinforcing, because I really don't need the one that it takes 50% less damage when it's over 90%, so I gave him a nice other bonuses. Okay, as you can see, I only have him at 2-star, and his abilities are, the tactical is recovering. It adds recovering to him, which heals approximately 300 every time it's his turn. And guarded, which reduces the incoming attacks damage and accuracy by 40% for one attack on him. It's pretty nice, actually. It's kind of like Groot. Groot only has recovering on his tactical, but he can put it on anybody. But since Captain can't, he also has guarded on his, so pretty nice. He's in at this whenever he hops in. He removes all mental, physical, and tactical debuffs from allies. It's pretty crappy. We haven't really messed around with the swapping in system yet, so maybe, you know, with a team that swaps in and out constantly, it might work. I have Provoking Strike here on him, Protecting and Fortified on 2-star upgrade. I haven't upgraded anything. This is like first look at him. And it looks pretty good. Second ability is Shield Toss. It costs his retaliation. Okay, yeah, let's actually go through it here. There we go. Retaliation is generated when a character is attacked. Some abilities require and consume all retaliation when used. The speed of the action is increased based on the amount of retaliation consumed. Basically, what it looks like is if you have max retaliation, it becomes an extremely fast ability. If you have 4, it becomes a fast ability, and 3 a normal, and so on and so on. 2 slow, you know, 1 very slow. Okay, let's continue here with this ability. Shield Toss does a lot of damage, as you can see. Guardian Maneuver, 217 damage, and if you do it up to 4 stars, 425. So it does a lot of damage, actually. So if I just could, you know, get him higher starred and better ISOs to increase his attack to around, you know, 2,800, 3,000 at least, and his accuracy up to 3k as well. That would really help his Shield Toss ability to do some real damage. Third ability I have loaded is Frontline Charge. It adds Clobbered and Crushed. Crushed is good on blunt attacks. Most melee attacks that are unarmed are blunt. And then we also have the shield attacks and the hammer attacks. Captain America and Thor, for example. Okay, as you can see, I don't have unlocked a lot of his abilities, but Patriot Challenge is a protecting ability, just like Provoking Strike, but you don't do any damage and it has a 3 turn cooldown. It also applies Demoralized on all the enemies, pretty nice actually. And if you update it to 4 star, you can use it every other turn, and so pretty hefty debuff actually. Reduces next attack's damage and accuracy by 30%. It's not bad, actually. And then we have the Cable Body Slide ability, Rally the Troops. It costs all retaliation, but it gives a free turn to the character you use it on, and increases the next attack's damage and accuracy by 40%. And if you start to 4 stars, you can get it to 2 turns cooldown. It's not bad at all. Then we have Martial Justice, applies off balance to one enemy, and applies readied to himself. basically he gets to retaliate after every attack against him, since he's protecting most of the time. And 4 stars, it applies ready to all heroes. It's not bad either. And we have Bastion of Liberty. Exploit schemes. This attack deals 50% damage to targets as a tactical debuff and shield breaker. That's a fair amount of damage and it's a shield breaker, but meh. And lastly, we have his ultimate ability, Tour of Duty. It's a rapid attack and applies strength to himself. And it's fast, it's 4 stars actually, so it's not that bad. But we're gonna go with these abilities. And my thinking here was, when I because I would like to exchange Groot, to try out another tank. I've been using Groot for months and months. So you know, and I don't want to use Wasp. So let's find a tank that has some purple ISOs. And Age of Ultron Captain America does have 2 purples. So let's see how it performs. Without further ado, let's go into some PvP. See how it goes. Okay, let's take out Age of Ultron Hawkeye. See if he can tank the stuff up here. Oh, I'm facing a rank 18 dude. But he has Miles and an Electro. I actually recognize the name. It's an old beta tester. So his dudes might be actually be good, even though he's rank 18. Okay, let's start off with Panther's Grace to give my Captain America an invasion buff. Oh, nice, dodged everything. Okay, let's hop on up. Took them all out. So we didn't get to see Captain America in action there. Okay, let's continue. Oh, we're rank 6 here now. Facing a regular Captain America, Ant-Man and Electro. This might be interesting. Let's see, shall we? Again, as always, Panther's Grace to increase his evasion. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Ant-Man took him down to like half life already. And that with his 50% lowering of damage. Okay, it's his Captain America now. He's just chilling. Okay, did I put on... yeah, I did put on alert. Okay. Time to take out his Captain America. Gonna do a lot less damage now because he put on guarded, but that didn't matter. Okay, he's stunned, so he'll just walk it off like a man. Okay, and it's probably all she wrote. No, maybe not. I maybe can do. Ah, he's stealthed, so I can't see him. Lol. I was like, what? And that's all she wrote. No, okay, that's interesting. I had distracted on him, but I didn't get to attack him because none of my characters can attack stealthy characters. That was interesting. Didn't know it actually. If you can't attack them with distracted because they're stealthed and you can't attack stealth target, you don't get to attack. Very interesting. Come on! Jesus. Finally, stealth 2 ended. Okay, that wasn't all she wrote. Okay, let's see what happens here now. I put on a shield, so he's good game now. Ballerina's gonna take care of him. Or not, actually, because the shield... Wow, I only did like 200 damage. Okay, but now I can finally attack here. I put on alerted again, because it fell off. I really want my... evasion here now because he's doing a lot of damage. Jesus, man. This is Electro, man, taking care of business. Holy crap. And now he's gone. Wow, that was a pretty interesting fight, actually. Okay, let's do a last one here. See if I can actually do something on cap besides just put on protecting. But this probably will be a longer fight. It's Angela and Wasp and Rocket Raccoon. He's only ranked 13, but they are good characters, all of them. So let's see what happens. Okay. Yep, grazed. Rocket Raccoon's attack. Captain America. So it's pretty nice. See if he can... okay, put on Panther's Grace. To give my tank alerted. Yep, Grace. This is why I was, you know, thinking of using him just to get the graces and dodges. Without us resorting to using a wasp. Oof. Ah! No! Okay. Yeah, Captain is gonna have to work here now. To actually get something going. Let's see, it's not looking good at all. Ah! No! No grace! From the man. Ah, of course, she graced. And of course my stealth dropped, so... Oh my god, thank god he dodged everything from Manila. Whew. Okay, time bomb. Yeah, my poor Captain America, he's gonna die. So let's do a shield toss here. Before I go down. Sweet! Took down Angela. Okay, so it's 1v2. Why aren't you in stealth, dude? Does he still have... revealed? Yeah, one more round. Okay, let's put on Distracted on Rocket Raccoon. See if I survive his attack now and we can get to attack back. No, of course not. Let's take Rocket out. Because I know I can hit him. Oh, dodge. Oof. Ow, so much wounded. Well, we only have one shot here. Do we? Yeah, wounded. And time bombed. Yeah, it's gonna be good game here, I think. If I don't take her out now. No, I didn't. And now I'm gonna die. Yeah. Yeah, so interesting team. Definitely. Okay, let's do one more. Just so I can get my PP roulette here as well. I'm facing Hulk, Angela and Electro. So far, not super impressed by Captain America. He took out Angela though, so that's pretty nice. I'm gonna put him through some PV as well, to see what he's made of. Okay. Put on evasion for everybody. Then we go with Deadly Ballerina. Take out Angela, that's nice. Okay, gonna protect as well. Select the Mighty Hulk. Now it's time to take out Electro. Nice, 6000 crit in your face. Now it's time to take out Hulk. Black Widow touching him on the hand and singing a little lullaby to him. Just like in the movie. Okay, take a shield toss to the face then. And that's all she wrote. 700 damage and a guardian maneuver. Yeah. We'll see how he performs in PV though. But he did get a fair amount of graces and dodge though. So that's always good. Okay, we got a belligerent isolate fragment. Okay, let's continue. And let's put him through some PvE, shall we? Okay, mission spec oops. Let's go for mission 3. See how he performs in here. So far, I'm pretty lukewarm. With Captain America, Age of Ultron. I am personally using Groot, so I'm comparing to Groot, not Wasp. And I know Groot is worse than Wasp. So, and it's the, if I'm lukewarm with the Age of Ultron, then to be fair though, he's not a star, a three-starred or again crashed because he didn't restart it. The game. So I'm using Groot as a model to compare his tankiness from, and he's not the best tank as well. So take that into account. So we'll see. My hope was that I could get a good tank with you know, around 5,000 evasion pumped out and 5,000 defense, because defense doesn't do a whole lot. Yeah, you need it, you know, 3,000-4,000, it does a lot, but after that, yeah, it doesn't really do that much anymore. Add in, you know, 5,000 evasion to that, so you get dodges and graces constantly, and if you have a fair amount of accuracy and attack, you could also do some damage with him, especially with his shield toss, because Groot can do zero damage, like literally zero damage, when he's in, when you have specced him out for tanking. So I was hoping to, you know, be able to do some damage with him. Didn't look like that. Okay, let's see him in action here now then. Okay. Let's put on Panther's Grace, just so we can have some extra evasion before. Let's see what he has in evasion now. Oh, that was Black Widow. Yeah, 5,000 evasion, and I haven't put on protecting yet, so I'm probably around 5,000 defense as well. It's not bad at all. Basically, my Groot has like, I think, 8,000 defense and 3,000 evasion, so it's a huge improvement stat-wise on my Groot, but the Groot has a lot better abilities for tanking than Cap does. So, so far, not 100% happy with him. Okay, let's see what his stats is now here. 4,500 in defense. As I said, it can also be because I haven't started him up, and I don't have, you know, super good ISOs on him. I have 3 to 4 stars, maybe a 1 or 2 5 star on him, and it makes a huge difference. And also, you can't 4 star Captain America Age of Ultron right now, so that's something to take into account as well if you want to put resources into him. So, my estimation of Age of Ultron Captain America is lukewarm. I would put him at the middle of the pack. And tanking wise, definitely below Groot, and Groot below Wasp. So, and probably below Luke Cage as well, actually, because Luke Cage is pretty good. He's also below Groot, so on the totem pole for tanking, he's pretty low, even with his two purple ISO slots. So I would not recommend putting resources into him as he is right now. They definitely need to pump him up a bit, maybe even give him some kind of rework, like they did Black Panther and Widow, because face it, the tanks in the game, all of them basically need a rework to become better, to be comparable to Wasp. Or the defense mechanism has to be improved. Because right now, evasion owns defense, which means all the tanks in the game except Wasp are pretty bad compared to her, because she's the only evasion tank. So, yeah, they definitely need to pump up defense, the value of defense by at least 30-40%, and lower the value of evasion by maybe, you know, 20-30%. And the swing there will be around 40-70. That would be really, really nice for the defensive tanks in the game, and it would bring Wasp a bit more in line. But this is about Captain America Age of Ultron, and my recommendation is don't bother, there are better tanks in the game. So until next time, have a good game.